that point of the show where we normally play the quiz show even more of them now with even more. And yes, we have loved the idea today, but we can't be bothered to come with a new segment. So we're rebranding, even though basically it's just Ant versus Dec, but we can't call it Ant versus Dec because that name's already taken. So it's some jazzy new graphics to hide the fact that we're doing the same old stuff as before. It's just Ant and Dec playing games. Atta! Here we go again. It's time to play to tell the truth. Now, here's how it works. You're going to meet three guests who will all claim to be the same person, but only one of them is telling the truth. The other two are imposters. You weren't expecting that. No. Let's do it together. Here we go. And
the other two are imposters.
Beautiful work. Right.
I preferred it when it was crappy. It's a bit too professional for that.
Right, before we play, fingers on your buzzers. Which one of you has never told the other that they didn't stop them eating a dog treat muffin?
Remember the other week when we went back to mine after watching Newcastle play?
Yes.
And we'd had a few beers.
Yes.
And there was some little muffins on the cooler rack.
They were nice. My wife.
They were cakes for the dog.
Yum, yum, yummy! Let's meet our players. Please introduce yourselves and your story.
My name is Lee, and I have Ant and Dec's faces tattooed on my bum.
Number two.
Hi, my name is Lee, and I have Ant and Dec's faces tattooed on my bum.
Number three.
Hi, my name's Lee. I've got Ant and Dec titled on my bum.
Right, OK. Clearly, one of them is completely off their nuts. Your first question, please.
Number one, how long did the tattoo take?
It took about 2.5 hours.
Same question, number three. How long did the tattoo take?
About 4 hours.
Each. So that's
four each.
Each?
Yeah.
That's quite a difference.
Wow, Dec?
Number two, have you got any other tattoos on your body?
I have, yeah. Just one.
So, tension music, please. Ant, who are you going for?
I'm going for number three.
Dec, number three as well. Will the real Lee please step forward? All right, guys. Yeah! Well done, but look, we've got to see it. I'll take a picture. I'll take a picture. Hang on. I'll take a picture. Because I can't tell who's who. There you go. It's Lee!
Well done, Lee. Congratulations. Well done.
Listen, now it's a tie break. So now,
yes.
One of these two here does have a tattoo.
Right.
And it's of Dean Gaffney. This is a fact. But which one is it?
It can't be.
And
you've got to go two. It can't
be. You're going for number two. You're going for number one? With the person who's got Dean Gaffney tattooed on them. Step forward. Yes! Let's see it then.
Oh my God.
And that was Tell the Truth.
Yeah. Come on, guys.
So after that diabolical message, 1-0 to Ant. Tune in next week for another edition of Ant and Dec Playing Games and to find out if we've come up with a proper title for it. Athan! And now it's time to play what was previously called the Quiz Show Even More Marathon, now with even more. And no, we haven't figured out a snappy new name for it. So we've literally gone out of this world and into space with these graphics. In what can only be described as a galactic waste of time and money in order to try and make it look shiny. And no, but the simple fact is, it's just Ant and Dec playing games in space.
But not
really. Yes, they have finally let us play it. I can't believe it either. It's Mastermind! Here we go, let's do it. Still going.
Oh, it's quite so good.
Right, let's crack.
John. Right, here's how it works. Our players will have to answer as many questions as they can on their specialist subject. But before we do anything, let's meet the real star of the show. It is the chair.
Yes, the chair!
Oh, yeah. The real deal. Will our first contestant please take to the chair?
What are you doing?
Your name, please?
Andrew Portland.
And your occupation?
TV host.
And your specialised subject?
Declan Donnelly.
And why not? Lighting change. Make sure you get it on the money.
There you go, thank you.
That's it. Right. Your 1 minute starts now. When is Dec's birthday?
25th of September.
Correct. What are Dec's middle names?
Joseph Oliver.
Correct. How many siblings does Dec have?
Six.
Correct. Who is the eldest sibling?
Patricia.
Wow, yes. What game caused Dec's biggest argument with you?
Who wants to be a millionaire?
Correct. What was the first record Dec bought?
Gold Brown by the Stranglers.
How do you know this? Yes. What is Dec's favourite karaoke song?
Piano Man, Billy Joel.
Correct. What was Dec's first car?
MG Metro, Turbo.
Turbo.
Dec has appeared in Alien Autopsy, but what other film?
Love Actually.
Correct. In feet and inches, how tall is Dec?
I've got no idea. 5 foot... six?
Yes! Oh, yeah! What's Dec's shoe size?
Seven.
Yes! What kind of dance did Dec do as a child, apart from body popping?
Irish dancing.
Correct. Where does... Oh! No, but I started, so I'll finish. I've always wanted to say that! Here we go, last question. Where does Dec fit in age order of his siblings?
He, in age order, bottom.
Yes, he's the youngest. Yeah. Wow, wee! And you scored 13 versus her!
I didn't know half of them.
Will our next contender please take his seat?
Yeah. Right. It's close, isn't it?
Right, your name, please.
Declan Donnelly.
Your occupation?
International playboy.
What? Your specialised subject?
The life and times of Anthony McPartland.
OK. Your time starts...
Where's my light and change?
Light and change. Thank you.
No torch?
Not at the back.
Not at the back of the head.
Not at the back.
Play the game, that's it. Very nice. Here we go. Your time starts now. When is it Ant's birthday?
18th of November.
Correct. What is the name of Ant's mother?
Christine.
Correct. What was the second song at Ant's wedding?
I Predict a Riot.
Correct. How many sisters does Anne have?
Two.
Yes. What are these sisters called?
Sarah and Emma.
Correct. What did Ant buy you for Christmas?
A pair of Nike trainers.
Correct. What's Ant's favourite kind of takeaway?
Chinese.
Correct. Where did Ant get engaged?
Dubai.
Correct. Where did Ant's mum work?
Marks and Spencer's.
Correct. What would Ant have as the starter of his death row meal?
Greg's sausage roll.
Yes, very precise. What's Ant's favourite position on the pitch?
Goalie.
Correct. Does Ant wear tight whiteies or boxer shorts?
Tight whiteies.
No, boxer shorts. What's Ant's favourite pizza topping?
Pepperoni.
Just in. Well done, but not good enough. The winner this week is Ant! Yeah!
So, after that astronomical mess, Ant is 2-0 up. Tune in next week for more Ant vs. Dec, but not Ant vs. Dec. And to find it, we fired our graphics guy.
Idiot. It's now time for Ant and Dec playing games, but we spent all our budget on last week's special effects. So we've got nothing to splash out on the graphics this time, which is why you're watching the title sequence created by an 8-year-old, because we didn't have to pay him any money. His only demand was that we show a picture he drew of a giraffe. He's just down at that playing games. Here's the giraffe, job done. And here's a cat. I did that one. I know, can't believe it either. We're still here. It's time for the Saturday Kitchen Omelette Challenge!
We're not dancing to the Saturday Kitchen theme tune.
It does count as a game show.
Does it?
Yeah.
Go on, then.
It's the Saturday Kitchen Omelette Challenge! Oh, they are!
how it's going to work. It's a head-to-head to make a three-egg omelette quickest. Now, it's not about finishing fastest. You'll be pleased to hear, Dec. It is about the taste. Now, very important, before we do anything... Ridiculous. Oh, God, these props. There it is.
You shocked yourself then.
Right, put your pinnies on. Here we go. There you go. Lovely jubbly. Put mine on as well. And they're nice.
That's good.
And they're nice. Right, get yourselves back behind into position. Lovely stuff. Now, let me just get my clock out. Grow up. Right. Are you ready?
Yes. Ready, Steve.
Your time starts now. Go. Right, they are off. And it's... He's gone. Oh, Dec's gone straight in the pan. That's it. Oh, I tell you what. There we go. The good thing is, we've got you nice small space. Oh, this is a diabolical mess. They are not messing about. Well, he seems ready to go by the look of it. Oh, look at that. How about that? Oh, they're both plated. Oh, very pretty. Let's just have a little look on the old close-up. There's Dec.
Good.
There you go.
That looks tasty.
How about that? And look at Ant.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah,
yum, yum, yummy. How about that? Now, we do have a renowned chef to judge. Hang on a second. Delia, yeah? No? Not even Ainsley. Oh, who we got? It's Aldo Zilli! Yeah! Aldo, that's it. Get yourself over here, Aldo.
Oh, you're right.
You jump in the middle.
Good to see
you. Aldo, can you believe this? Wow, this is actually on ITV2.
I know.
Now, Aldo, this is the serious moment here. You need to taste and just decide who is the tastiest. Remember, it's not who finished first. Ooh. That's it. Oh, hello. Ooh. Right, Aldo, make your mind up. Whilst you're doing that, let's have a bit of tension music, please.
Come on.
Thank you, John. Cut it! Right, Aldo, have you decided? Well,
so, the winner is...
Yeah! Look, it's as though he's actually won something worthwhile! There you go, and that was Saturday Kitchen! Nice work, Aldo! Beautiful! Well done, you! Yeah. Well done! No way!
So after that culinary catastrophe, it's 2-1 to Ant. Tune in next week for more Ant Dec playing games and hopefully some proper graphics so we don't have to show these drawings anymore. I'll grow up. Now it's time for Ant Dec playing games. Yes, we've managed to scrape some money together and got some guy called Howard to do some graphics. Unfortunately, Howard retired in 1983, so this is the best he could come up with. It's just Ant Dec playing games. There's Howard. Idiot.
Yes, here we go again. We are playing. Are you... No, I say that with excitement.
Oh, hooray!
Because you're going to love this one. It's only the celebrity name game.
Oh, a bit of coming down.
Oh, yeah. It's a beautiful thing. Now, before anyone says it, it's quite big in America. And basically, we've run out of shows.
Yeah.
It's been 11 series.
I know.
I think we've hung in there. We really have. But... which celebrity will you be playing with? Well, let me tell you now, on Ant's team, she has got an IQ of 200 and has even beaten Stephen Fry in a pub quiz. It is... Ooh. Megan McKenna! Here she is.
You all right?
Playing in for Dec, we've got someone that speaks 15 languages. Yes. Not one of them English. It is Charlotte Crosby! Right, here are the rules. Boys, you need to give clues to your celebrity guest. And all they've got to do is try and work out which celebrity is on this screen that will be behind them. Now, you're not allowed to say any part of the name, spell the name, or rhyme the name.
Right.
Otherwise, you'll be disqualified. And you can only pass three times. OK. Megan, good luck. Your time starts now.
He wasn't Strictly Come Dancing, he was a politician.
Pass.
Oh, it was Ed Balls.
Ed Balls. He was editor of the Daily Mirror, but now he's got a TV show. he's on Twitter all the time. He has rants with Alan Sugar.
It. I know it.
Yeah, you know it.
Well, just say it.
Danny.
Go on, then.
Danny.
Danny. No, it's not Danny.
Danny? Who's Danny? Oh.
Pass. Right, she's a judge on Britain's Got Talent.
Matt Holder.
Yes. Yay! He is an actor. He was in.
He's fit.
He's very fit.
Sorry,
Blinders. He was also in The Revenant.
No.
Just have a guess. He's a British actor.
Quite rough looking.
Oh! Oh!
It was Tom Hardy.
Tom Hardy.
Oh. I'm so.
We're gonna have to bleep.
They're really sorry. sorry. I'm right. So rubbish.
Good luck. You've only got one to beat.
Yeah.
And your time. Start now.
Oh, he's an actor.
Come on.
And his second name sounds like, oh.
Morn?
No.
Morn?
No.
Sorn?
We'll pass on that one. She takes selfies all the time. She's got a big bum.
Kim Kardashian!
Next one. Next one.
Her second name is...
Vagina?
No. She represents It Takes Two. Blonde hair presenter woman.
Holly Willoughby!
No, a second name is... same as the other guy.
Balls!
So that's her second name.
Conjoined Balls!
Yes! Oh, crikey.
Come on,
this is...
Meow, cat daily!
It was Pussy Galore.
Oh, I'm done!
Which means the winning team, it's Dec!
That was so much easier.
And that's the end of the game. Megan.
I'm embarrassed.
So after that, Dec has pulled things level at 2-2. Well done, Dec. Tune in next week for more Ant and Dec playing games, and maybe we can pay someone for some graphics from this millennium. Ship out, Howard.
World on a land at a time. Where people struggle to come up with names for game shows. Against all the odds, a team have pulled together to witness one man. No, two men. A warrior from the north battling a slightly shorter warrior from the north in a fight to the death.
Jeez, that was a bit much. It's just Ant and Dec playing games, guys. You're gonna love this week. Possibly. It's Don't Show Keep Your Teeth! Come on! Let's do it! Right, you're gonna need some teammates. So I have got the best in show business, well, the best our budget can buy. Playing for Ant, it's Sam Quek and Bear! Here they are. Right, player for Dec, we've got Melody and the Pussycat Dolls! Yeah. And we've got Beethoven! Let's crack on. I'm going to give you all a category, and all you've got to do is say a word associated with that category right. Without showing your teeth. Now,
okay.
I am the judge, so I've got the final decision, so don't even try and bother arguing. You're not allowed to hesitate, and above all else, you're not allowed to show your teeth.
Okay.
This is showing your teeth, of course. This is not showing your teeth.
Okay. It's the team with the last man standing who will win the game.
Okay.
Yeah. Very yeah. good. Here we go. Okay. The category is British Got Talent.
Contestant.
Next.
Judges.
Judges.
Singing.
Singing. Very good. Oh! Yeah.
Okay.
What?
Horseman.
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 Horseman. Horseman. No.
Animal.
Animal. He actually sounds like he's just talking normal. Stay. Oh! Oh! I used to say your teeth. Oh, no. Right. Deck, continue.
Dancing dogs.
Dancing dog, very good.
Fire thrower?
Thrower!
Fire thrower! Fire blowers?
Fire juggler!
Fire juggler! Oh no, you crushed your teeth! You crushed your teeth! You crushed your teeth! Yeah, you crushed your teeth!
Mom and Pow!
Mom and Pow, dead!
Quiet!
Quiet!
Church. A church.
A church?
A church.
That's ridiculous. You're out.
It's a church. Choir's in a church.
Dick.
Talented children.
Talented children? There you go.
Look.
Look.
Milk.
Milk. Under deck, but he's already said and. Under deck, right? And.
Stephen Mulhern.
Stephen Mulhern, very good.
Jugglers.
We've already had jugglers, which means this week Ant is the winner! Oh no!
Losers! So after that round, it's now 3-2 to Ant. Tune in next week to see them face off again and even more flying words. Fantastico.
Over the last 5 painful weeks, we've attempted to come up with a name for what is basically just Ant Dec playing games. And now after losing the will to live multiple times, we've finally decided to call this item...
Ant Dec playing games. Really? And here's the logo. Really? No. That's just a plate of chips. That's Ben Shepherd. That's an actual shepherd. Oh, let's just get on with it.
Oh, yes, you're going to love it. It's only cat trains.
Yeah!
Yes, it
love
is
it.
Cat trays on
love
the
it.
Telly.
Love it!
They actually genuinely do.
We do.
Now, because as long as they love it, they maybe keep it on the telly. So, let's have a little look at the scores over the series so far. Ant is on 3. Deck just slightly behind on 2. Everything to play
all
for.
All to play
here.
For. Big prize at the end of it, is there?
Yeah, there'll be a big prize. He always gets a good prize.
Who knows it?
There's always a good prize.
Now, every correct answer gets you 1 point. So anyone could be our winner of the series. Let's get going. Cast your eyes to the screen. Just say what you see. Fingers on your buzzers. Good luck. Whoa! What is he? What does he do as a career? What's he just done? It's a clue. Ant.
Arty Farty.
It's Arty Farty! Yes.
Did he do a fart?
Yeah, it was a big bit of gas.
Yeah, can you play that one? Can you play it very quickly? There you go.
I mean, it would have helped with the sound effect.
That would, wouldn't it?
We got there. Yeah, we got there.
The fart.
Right, here's your next one. Think about what they are. What's the difference? Ant.
Big fish, little fish, cardboard box.
Big fish, little fish, cardboard box.
I saw that. I was just too slow at the buzzer.
Now the pressure is on, because if Ant gets the next one correct, he's won the title.
Love catcheries.
Right, fingers on your buzzers.
Love it!
What is he doing? Just think about what he's doing. Look, look.
Say what you see, boys.
What is he doing there?
Whoa!
Just say what you see. It's worth a guess. You can't be frozen out. Dec.
Flying with his underpants.
It's a famous phrase we all know and love. He's is flying it? By the...
And... By the underpants. By...
So close! Dec, he's flying by the seat of his pants. Now, it's getting hard in here. And gets the next one right, he's still won. Can Dec stay in play? Let's find out. Right, here's Mr. Chips. But what has he just got? What's the Dec?
He's just been given the sack.
He's been given the sack, yes! Which means it's now 5-4. Oh, this is so close. Here's your next one. Just say what you see. This is an easy one. Anyone can get this. What's he just done? Dec.
Jumping on the bandwagon.
He's jumped on the bandwagon! It's 5-all.
Come on.
Who's going to get it? Who's won this year? Here's your next catchphrase. What is Mr. Chips doing now?
And he's drying his eyes.
He's drying his eyes.
That's good for a spare quilt in the spare room.
Well done, let's hear it for today! Amazing!